Hello everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Terraria by Gladron468. We're here with episode 2, and today I'd actually like to start out with a show of what's to come. I'm just going to show you my two main worlds, just to show you basically how far I've gotten before and how far I plan to get in this Let's Play. And I'll also do some gameplay right afterwards. So, this is the world that I started out with this character. It's pretty basic. It's got a skyway all the way across, and there's no floating islands anymore because I completely demolished them. And chests and my hell forges and all of this stuff. It's just basic pre-1.1 stuff. Pretty much everything pre-1.1, and I've got a elevator here that goes down first to a mushroom farm and then eventually to hell, and I've got it completely backed with walls, and it's also lined with bricks, and I built pretty much everything out of gray brick in this world. So just go down to the bottom here. Shouldn't take all that long. And there's my mushroom farm. And we're down to the lava already. This is a small world, so won't take long. And here is hell. Should be. There we go. So I've basically got a nice little setup down here too. I found a cool hell house right below where I was digging, and I set it up to have the same things in it as my house upstairs, except for the sawmill. I need to make another sawmill if I ever come back to this world. I don't plan on it. This is just my pre-1.1 world, and basically that's all I've really done with this world. I've also, screwed around with the dungeon and stuff, but I've not done any building other than that. And what did I just get? Okay. So now I'm going to show you the world that I've been working on for the past week or so. And this is Len. And here's the one where I've got hard mode activated and everything. Okay, so this is what I... What? Oh, because it's not the holiday season anymore, that's right. But this is what I plan on making my house into. Just sort of an apartment block with chests and everything I need, so that I can spawn all the NPCs. But as you can see, I also got a little creative with it. I made a little candy cane man. And I've got another elevator. Sorry about that. My computer spazzed out a bit. But I've got another elevator here. Goes all the way down. And I actually haven't really made a second house down in hell yet on this world. The only thing I've really done is make a giant bridge, and just to spite hell, I made it out of snow. And I made it long enough so that I was able to defeat the wall of flesh the first time, and it was actually kind of hard to do. So, yeah, that's basically it. Just a bit of a preview of what's going to come eventually. And, actually, after I lay a few of these torches, which got destroyed by lava, there we go. I'll show you my equipment. So, I've already got an Unreal Mega Shark and a Mythical Crystal Storm, as well as a Legendary Excalibur. I haven't gotten this upgraded to Legendary yet. I tried, but didn't work. Same thing with this one and this one. But I have my Gungnir, my Dalpal, and my Hamdrax. I've upgraded all of my accessories with warding, because I enjoy having the extra defense. So I've got Ranger Emblem, Cross Necklace, the Diving Gear, GPS, Spectre Boots, I have Angel and Devil Wings, the Cloud in a Bottle, Philosopher's Stone, and the Obsidian Shield. And I've got an Obsidian Lucky Horseshoe around here somewhere too, but there's no need for it anymore because I have the wings. And I've got all of my Hallowed equipment, one of each helmet, as well as the chest piece and the legs. Got my fairy bell too, and I've got my magical harp in here somewhere. I think it's in here? Maybe here. Somewhere. There it is. I tried to get that one to mythical too, but it didn't work. Yeah, my hallowed repeater too. Which isn't that great. I was rather disappointed in it compared to the Mega Shark. But, yeah. So that's just pretty much a preview of what's to be coming eventually. And, I guess I'll head to my Let's Play world now, and we'll get started on that. So I was playing on Gladrin 2 in the world Mortania. That's right. I was doing another playthrough just for fun with a character named Man in a world named World. And I've noticed that this isn't going to be fun. Well, it's going to be fun, it's just not going to be easy. I'm going to die a lot. Okay, so how much money do I have? Just over 50 coins, so I can't quite buy that piggy bank. Which, it's not a big deal right now, but eventually we're probably going to be making a new world. And we'll want the piggy bank for that. But first, I wanted to rearrange this a little. Because my chest room, I'm not very pleased with it. And I know exactly what I can do to make myself a bit more pleased. Okay. Whoops. Put it right there. And we should be able to hammer that off. There we go. We're gonna move this floor down. That way we can store more chests in the same room. Grab my platforms, and we can get this started. 5, 6, 7, 8. 10. It'll work. Alright. Actually, that won't work. We're gonna have a door there. Okay. And put some platforms here. Now that I look at it, can we make this jump? No, we can't. Okay. It's gonna take a little fiddling. But I think this would work. Okay. There we go. Why did I put three? There we go. It's coming on nighttime. And I think I'm actually going to be going out tonight. We need to get a few extra slime gels too. So hopefully I'm able to finish this before nighttime hits. And the guide can die, that doesn't matter. Eight? Wait. Nine. And we'll take this one out. There we go. Now, we should be able to put our chests up there. And I'm going to do the same thing on the other side really quick. Now that I got it figured out, it's a little easier to do. I don't like that. Got our little shelves for our chests now. And I'm just going to lower our room here one more so that it's big enough to allow for everything we need in it. There's that. Nope. Nighttime now. You can hear all the little zombies and everything. And the music changed. There we go. Well, at least it didn't hit a blood moon. That wouldn't have been a good thing right now. Done with the interior decorating. Why is the merchant... Oh, that's right. He hasn't teleported up to his house yet, so he's just walking around aimlessly. Last walls destroyed. Put up my own wooden walls. Ah, you stupid guide. Or merchant. Whatever you are. Oh, I'm dead. Maybe not. Go, boomerang, go! Okay, I'm going to reset this merchant really quick. If you run to where you can no longer see an NPC, and it's nighttime and they have a house, or a room, or whatever, then they will just teleport right into it, and then they'll stand there for the rest of the night. They won't keep opening your doors and letting zombies in. While you're building. There we go. That should be all of it. Okay, we're good. Now, time to go out, and we'll see what kind of damage we can do. Oh, come on. I don't recommend using a boomerang to fight off demon eyes in real life, by the way. There we go. Is that our first lens? No, it's our second. I'm gonna store a couple of things in our chest before we go. So we'll probably get more of those, but we don't need to carry it around. Actually, most of this we don't need to carry around. Shurikens I'll keep. Oh, those doors I need to put down. We won't be getting any more of those candy canes anymore either. Tombstones. So iron blocks, or not iron blocks, but iron ore is what we're going to be looking for. Because we need to make an anvil. Or we could buy one from the merchant. But that's 50 silver. Okay, we're surrounded by zombies. It's also really lucky that we got Godly on this boomerang. Godly is the second best prefix for ranged weapons. Unreal is the best. That's what I had my Mega Shark and Hallowed Repeater up to on my other character. Away at that all they want. And I'm gonna see what lazy does. -8% speed, so that's not very good. 14% damage, 5% crit, and 15. Sorry, hit the recording button on accident. Oh, I did not see him. Our boomerang does more damage than a sword. Mushroom. Oh, missed that mushroom. I could probably carry around a torch, make it a little easier to see. Oh, that's copper. We're gonna die. Whew. Fire where they are, fire where they're going to be. Here we go. And that's our third lens. Just need three more and we'll be able to summon the first boss once we get a little better gear. We're dead. We're not dead yet. Oh, heart. Sweet. We're still dead. All right. That worked out a lot better than I ever thought it would. If you couldn't tell. Just grabbing this copper really quick. Stay out. There we go. I'm just gonna sit in here for the rest of the night. It's almost daytime. Can't see the moon anymore. There they go. Now all of the enemies should be leaving. It's safe to come out. Just beat him back really quick. There. All right. Score. Well, looks like this area's a little high for us to climb. So I'm gonna pickaxe my way up there. This might take a little while. Oh, never mind. It's all dirt. We should be good. There we go. We're gonna grab those mushrooms too, since we're desperately in need of items right now. And we're gonna move these mushrooms so that when we heal, it doesn't use them instead of our healing potions. Cause your character is too smart for healing potions. Slime had a vendetta against us. Oh, here's another cave. Alright. Hopefully we get some iron. Or maybe some silver. There's a chest somewhere around there. There's some iron. Sweet. So now when we go back to town, well, not town, but our house, we'll be able to start smithing our own gear. Copper bars, that's good. Arrows, never a bad thing. torches, good. Shine potion, I'm probably gonna end up selling that. Silver, almost have our first gold. And some glow sticks, those are always good too. Oop, this place is a little big. There. And over. I don't think we'll make that. Oh, crap. There we go. That's the thing about Terraria. I'm not a very quick thinker. It's a lot of times it takes a little bit of time for me to notice the obvious solution. Ooh, and that looks like a little hidden passage or something up there. Might be something useful. Nope. Just some arrows. Alright. Back down. Ooh! Spear. That's good. We'll be able to use that. And we have our first gold, too. Alright. We can use a few of these torches, it's no problem. We've got a bunch of them now. And, what's this? Copper? By any chance? Anything? Anything at all? Nope. Okay. Thought I'd saw some copper. Ooh. Back up. Because there was a passage over here that we didn't take. I'm probably missing some ores. Not paying enough attention right now. I'm actually kind of tired. Gonna be going back to school really soon, so I've got to start getting used to waking up early again. Grab these torches back. Don't know how that works. Oh! There we go. Ooh! Some more copper bars, shurikens, iron skin potion. Well, you need that basically at endgame, so we're gonna keep that for a while. And here's our first accessory. A Well, our first equipment, just plain. Some extra movement speed and melee speed. Okay. And, I'm gonna get up here. Ooh, another iron skin. There we go. And this is where we were before. Okay. So we'll grab those two torches back. And I keep forgetting to take these chests. Oh, and there's some iron. First iron ores of the game. And I almost missed them. But that is Terraria. Half of it's combat, the other half is completely screwing up. Which, don't worry. I'll do enough of that by the end of this Let's Play. There we go. 12, not bad. We're gonna go right first. Never mind, we're going left first. Cobwebs. They're actually useful in this game. Oh, lots of them right there. Going just a little deeper. Oh, and we're down to the next level of the earth, which means it's probably time to call it quits here and head back up to the surface. Okay. Crap. I'm probably gonna drown. I'm gonna drown. Place the blocks. Oh, yes. Oh. Aww. Alright. Now we should be able to take out this slime. There we go. We didn't drown. You know what? I never knew when to call it quits. Why start now? Oh. I forgot we made it this far down already anyways. There's another goldfish, and I think there's a chest down there too. Nope. Not a chest. Just those. We can kill another goldfish. Up we go. Ah. Stupid slime. There we go. Grab this copper. Now we should be able to make a good amount of armor when we get back. Ooh. Okay, so that was a falling boulder, and I did not see the pressure pad that made it release, and it's a good thing it didn't kill me. Normally they do. Oh, that's right. They don't light up while you're in the water anymore. I guess that can show you how long ago it was when I played. I'm not very good avoiding these traps. I'm gonna run into every one of them. Most of them are probably gonna hit me too. Is that silver that I was just standing on? So in hindsight, I guess I should have kept that stack of dirt blocks. There we go. Yep, silver. Might as well grab some of this clay too. Gonna die. Come on. There we go. Should be able to take it out this next pass. When it comes over here. There we go. Hunter potion. Ooh. Oh, I see. There was a jellyfish there, and it must have triggered the boulder somehow. Killed itself. Wooden arrow, copper coins. Oh. Was wondering what all those coins came from. That would be it. I'm not sure where the pressure plate's at, though. Oh, there it is. There we go. And look at this. We found some gems. And that's it. 5 emeralds. Nothing to complain about. And I'm going to grab this dart trap. We're not gonna make that jump. There we go. That's enough. Alright. Should be able to make a nice zombie defense at our house now. Oh. Wow. That was fun. Oh. Okay. So, oop. Nighttime. We're gonna make a silver bar. Some iron bars. Copper bars. Wow, I'm getting really bad frame rate right here for some reason. Make our anvil, put it down, and now we're ready to make some items. You don't really have enough iron bars to make anything good. I don't like using short swords. I prefer the broad swords, so I'm not gonna bother with that. But I will make copper chainmail. And I guess that's it right now. I'm gonna make some red bricks with a little bit of clay that we found. And look, we can make some green torches, but no. We're probably going to sell those emeralds. Make a few potions. And let's see what I can sell him. That we don't need. We've got a godly version. This we don't need anymore, now that we've got this spear. And, we'll save that. Ooh, goldfish are really worth 2 silver each? Oh, we lost that gold we had. Well, crap. Looks like that's all we're going to be selling for now. We might sell those later, but not yet. So I'm gonna put down my chest. It's gonna be our little treasure room. Grab my tombstone out. And let's see, I'm thinking about keeping my chest kind of sorted this time, unlike other games that I've played. So this will be blocks. No walls, just blocks. And bricks. And I think that should be it. Yep. Okay, so here's my ores and bars chest. Or actually, that would probably be a waste. So we'll come over here. We'll put in our... Actually, this will be building materials. And this can just be other blocks. Building materials. Bricks, glass... What else can be used to build? I think that's it. Items. Put some items in here. Items and potions. So this is gonna be a full chest for the most part. It's probably gonna end up being really, really full. See, that's much better than what we were using before. Oh, come on. Come on. Before it hits daytime. Come on. Aww. Alright. So I think I'm gonna find a good place to start our graveyard. And then I'm probably going to cut the video. Can't jump over it. Aww. Have an underwater graveyard. I wonder if that works. Wait, it wouldn't work there. There's trees in the background. Throw the tombstone. Nope. Doesn't work the way I planned it would. Oh well. We're just going to line this whole area with tombstones. And we're probably going to have a lot more after that, too. So we'll see. Alright. So next episode, hopefully we can get two more pieces of armor to get started out on our set. And, I don't know, a few other things. But before I go, craft a few of these. Torches. And there we go. So this has been Gladron468 with episode 2 of Let's Play Terraria. And I'll see you guys later. Farewell.